No wedding would be complete without the parents and the new in-laws. Fiona, Tim, Lynn and Barry. You should be very proud of these two, and I'm sure they will flourish as a married couple, as they have strong role models to lead by.
Always. Always. Get the name of the barman when you go to a pub. Absolute gem. Gem of advice from Tim.
I've known Rory for literally the whole of his life. And we've evolved through life together, not learning nearly as much as we should, and no one forgetting the rest. And we've been lucky enough to have great families, but also to have been brought up by almost a community of great men and women that we've known since we've been born. The railway tavern in Billericay has been a constant in both of our lives, from meeting there as babies, to energetic kids constantly watching the England football team lose at every major tournament, to sort of passable adults getting some beers on the side, to whatever the hell you call us now. As far as I can remember, Roy was an interesting child. And he used to have a myriad of different compulsive tics. So one was sort of a... which we had a time chart in a geography lesson, and he did 23 times in an hour. What a cycle. And also a strange squeal. He used to be able to try and...
He still does that.
Rory, give us a squeal.
Just constantly playing with your gentleman sausage.
Yeah, we have noticed that, Rory. To be fair, Rory is a very proud man. He's a very proud man. I've never seen a 16-year-old kid wear a t-shirt saying, "Cassive Mock." That is as familiar as Rory.
Nonetheless, though, I mean, he still has to be like a lady.
Surprisingly to some of you, Rory's a pretty cool guy now, but he didn't always used to be as hip and rock and roll as he is today. But he always had a romantic heart for Ryan Gosling, as we've been shown in the last 10-15 minutes. When he was 12, in front of half of our year group, in the middle of the corridor of school, he gets down on one knee. Will you go out with me and present a box of Galliard chocolates? She laughs and runs away. Or she laughs whilst running away, I don't know. It did work. Rory, emboldened still, 2 years later asks a girl if she'd like to go on a date to a Lord of the Rings convention. Letting that sink in, this particular girl happened to have slightly pointy ears that kind of look like an elf. And I think she just took offense to that. we've been together a long time and we've done a lot of stuff together. The school, playing music, skiing trips, dressing up as leopards, three peaks challenges, Rory wearing a kilt for no bloody reason, going to university, constantly outladding me on my own turf. Why aren't you as cool as your friend Rory? Which I constantly heard. We obviously already mentioned before playing for sports under the sun, saying we were somehow equal. I don't think that's true. Rory is the David Beckham of James Batty. Yes, absolutely. We're placed on the side, I'll shout, "Get back, Rory!" And then Rory shouts at me because I can't make a 10-yard pass. That's not true. A quick shout out to our Rory and I seven aside football team, who, after 4 years of trying, finally won our league title tonight. Come on, boys. Come on, boys. Sadly, our team name is still not in your mum's forest. Sorry, Flea. Sorry, mum.
What? What? Not in your mum's forest.
Rory's my brother. And he always has, and he always will be.
For me, I'd like to mention how honoured I am to be asked to be a best man. My friendship with Rory spans over 6 years, which isn't really that long, As opposed to, as Evi said, you know, Rory and Evi's friendship, who's gone through since, you know, being really little and gone through so many sports and set aside and, you know, going on skiing and other sort of family holidays and stuff. It's something that Rory and I don't really share an interest in. You know, we don't really do football. I know what football is. that's about it. And it got me thinking, over such a short period of time, what is it that made Rory choose me to be one of his best men? Is it the bond that we shared when we woke up together after a night out in my bed? Very neighbored. Maybe applying each other's guideliner to go and see a super cool rock band. Whichever it is, I'm very grateful, so thank you. During this time, though, he has changed considerably. Our first initial meet, as I've now discovered that he's touched upon, was during the summer of 2009 when I was a freshman at university. I was invited over to a table one evening by one of our rushers, James Lane. We chatted over a beer. James Lane from Cambridge was very civilised. After a short while, though, the two became a three when this overwhelming, loud, blonde Bon Jovi figure emerged, carrying two pints and sat down next to James. Bandana, Rolling Stones t-shirt, Cuban heels, the words. I'll always say this about Rory, he really knows how to make an impact and enter the room. We didn't really have much to say to one another, so I just sat and was politely interested in both James and Rory's overwhelming love for going out for drinks to Liverpool Street.
And I don't know if there are many people here that know Rory that haven't been to the mayor of Scaredy Cat Town Bar for overpriced whiskey cocktails. If you want to know, Rory will take you. Bloody loves it.
After this, we met once again during lunch at uni. This time, both wearing a leather jacket, both wearing a Rolling Stones t-shirt, both wearing Cuban heels. I wasn't sure how this went down, but now, after his speech, I finally discovered that he thought I was an ass. I got a sense that you were eyeing me up, thinking, who is this clown on my turf? This weird vibe, though, suddenly disappeared as he proceeded to fit a whole pint glass around his mouth and he had done it long ago. So he couldn't be that hung up about it. So putting it all together, blonde hair, dressed like a rock star, what's the catch? One karaoke night was the first time I ever heard Rory Taylor sing. Now, still being in a band with Rory, I can touch on this subject. Okay, up next, ladies and gentlemen, we have Rory Taylor singing, I believe, in a thing called Love by the Darkness. I stand and I go, he can't hit those high notes. Not only did he hit the high notes, he went past the note and extended it by a considerable amount of time, on his knees, spinning the mic sound. Winston Churchill had never seen such a performance. A combination of witnessing karaoke and a drunken open mic night jam led us to start a band, which still plays a very big part in our friendship today. His natural determination, musical ability, and competitiveness, which can only be driven by years of sports, makes him a superb frontman. Infuse that with the dynamic of our fabulous rhythm section, who, surprisingly, still relatively sober. This makes a great group of us to be a part of. During his third year, he certainly wanted to live out his rock and roll persona, and made some interesting choices regarding lady friends. And this was perfectly acceptable. This is what you do at uni. What wasn't so acceptable was bumping into the poor girl in a bar after they'd been together and opening a conversation with, Hello, Kirsty. It's Katie. Now those days are long gone and he's found one true love with Janice.
Jenny. In the summer of 2011, Rory and I decided to get really good at tempered bowling. That was the plan. It was amazing. I bought my own bowling ball called Clarence. And Rory had his own bowling shoes. Combined, we actually formed a complete bowler. And we played. We played six to 12 games a day, every Monday, for about 9 months. And seeing as Rory has allowed soppiness into our speeches, I would be adequately soppy as well. On many occasions, this particular 9 months was a very difficult time for me, and being able to see my friend for once a week, for 3-4 hours, and just forget about everything else, and just walk into a conversation with someone I loved, just even just once a week, it was, I can't show you how appreciative I am of that. Really essential, and always there, whether it's a game of bowling, or a couple of pints at the pub, or dragging you to a rock gig, or, it's not meant to push it! Or, you know, watching episodes of Sharp. Also, Barry, you mentioned about watching like lady TV shows. You realise that Rory is the reason they're watching Desperate Housewives. But seasons 1-8, it's not bloody Jenny. I'm always there for people, and he's always been there for me, and I found that particularly important. Yeah.
For me, I always find Rory is very positive about love. Whether it's going to work on a wet Monday morning, having loads of work to do, having a bad gig where no one turns up, he still looks on the bright side of life. He is so determined to achieve his goals and puts 100% into anything. Something of an inspiration, I think. You know, you really are an influence on me, man.
Now to the amazing Brian Jenny. It's a great and strange thing to have someone important sort of tumble into your life. And anyone with a magnitude to match up to Rory definitely deserves merit. And Jenny definitely deserves merit.
Yeah. I'm going to touch slightly on one of my earliest memories of Jenny, which was up in Edinburgh during the Fringe. We were all out on the town together in some seedy alternative rock bar, and some sizable Scottish man throughout the night knocks over my drink. Sorry, pal. Oh, no, that's okay. Excuse me. No, that's not okay. You just knocked over my friend's drink. I think you should go and buy him another one. Honestly, Jenny, it's fine. No, it's not okay. Honestly, it's fine. Oh, yeah, don't Jenny go. Don't Jenny go, please. What an ogre of a man to be put in his place with his hair between his legs, scurrying off to refill my glass. It was at this very point I knew Jenny was the right girl for Rory. Strong-minded, feisty, and always looking out for her friends. In all seriousness, she genuinely is the perfect match for him.
Yay!
I remember when I first met Jenny, which was the night that Rory first met Jenny. And we're out on a football night out to Brentford, of all Tower places. The dignity of the group means we didn't go to the Sugar. So we went to the nearest mediocre music dance place we could find, Eclipse. So a couple more pints later, some side steps, and Rory's getting on this quite attractive looking lady blonde. Oh, we're getting this. Did he do? and then we came home and I couldn't find Rory for 3 weeks. Literally. Just, oh, he's busy, he's mysteriously busy.
It's our house.
Finding each other. And I first year, so I couldn't find the bastard for 3 weeks until he texted me saying, would you like to meet this girl called Jenny? I was like, yeah, okay. I don't think I've actually been asked in that way before. Anyway, we go, the three of us, we meet something in the Crown Pub. Sorry, lads. had a great time. And, 3-4 hours, 5 hours, as if I'd, you know, known Jenny for years. I reckon I'm more pathetic than Fiona. I don't know when you said. As we left that night, we passed a place. The old man hugged me, Rory, and I looked in his eye, and I could tell that this was different. And honestly, hand to God, I've been thinking about today since then. Since 3 weeks after we met, and I met Jenny for the first time, and the dynamic was obviously there. It was always there. So today, we don't lose a bro.
We officially gain a lady.
So, here are the two glasses.
And please, join us in a toast. Wishing you all the happiness in the world. Thank you for being you.
to Rory and Jenny.
Rory and Jenny.